You know, Siddharth, my father was neither an employee nor an employer. For 30 days in my life, I was a BCom student. Because the BCom fees was 100 rupees less than BSc fees. One great chemistry professor, Dr. K.R. Karthikeyan, he took me, paid that extra 100 rupees and converted a BCom student into a BSc student. And I salute him because without him, I would have not been what I am.
Velumani's 4G. You've obviously figured out what those 4Gs are all about. Episode number 3, Jiha, Guts, Grits, Growth and Glory. I am Siddharth Kannan and these are the philosophy of life from a gentleman who's gone through the highs, the lows, and he doesn't consider the lows as lows, he considers them as his biggest strength. How to be the architect of your own life? We shall find out from the man who's an iconic entrepreneur and owns a company called ThyroCare, which is revolutionary when it comes to selling wellness packages. And of course, his humility personified, but you get to learn so much from him. Welcome back, sir.
I said that.
I like your jacket, looking good.
Yeah, this is my daughter's selection. And I'm happy today it got an opportunity to get to the camera.
No, but you don't use this jacket too often. Why is that?
I'm normally a man with black and white. I was born black and white. I love black and white and I remain with black and white.
So is your entire life black and white or are there shades of grey as well?
I think shades of grey is always there, but we always call as black as black, white as white. In between, we don't bother about what it is.
So last time we spoke about how you finished your graduation. But in this whole scenario of things, how does one become the architect of your own life? How did you become the architect of your own life?
Now, in that way, I came to Mumbai by telling lies to my mother. We can call as white lies. I was about to get only 800 rupees per month salary. But if I tell it is 800, my mother would not permit me to go to Mumbai. So I told it is 1600. And she was very happy. It is more or less my college professor's salary. So she was extremely happy. I came to Mumbai. A good child is a child who saves at least 70% of his income and gives to the mother till he gets married. And I didn't want to be a bad child. So now I have to send 1,000 rupees per month home. Now my salary is only 800. How will I send 1,000 rupees per month home? Then I started looking for odd jobs. Paper delivery, I have done in Chembur for 6 months. Milk delivery, I have done in Ghatkopar for 6 months. Then I understood these are all jobs only illiterate people do. I should do tuitions. I picked up one tuition, two tuition, three tuition, four tuition, five tuitions each day I was doing till I found 1600 per month I had in hand. I sent 1,000 rupees per month to my home. I believe as long as you love your mother and as long as you don't do anything that your mother doesn't like, you will be the biggest personality on this earth.
So this episode we're going to be dedicating to all our mothers out there. Thank you so much for making us the personalities that we are.
Absolutely.
You know, there is an interesting anecdote from your life that you gave a lot of job interviews, but you were continuously rejected. Why were you rejected? Because you were not fit enough for the job? Were you because you didn't have that finesse to give the interviews? Were you nervous during interviews? Why so many rejections?
See, one unfortunate part is all or 99% of the interviews are held in English. In a country where 95% people study in vernacular medium, everybody is questioning somebody in English and that person struggles to answer only in English, and in English he fails, and because he fails in English, he is failed in his life. I want to tell, English is just a language. English is not knowledge. Don't test languages. Please test knowledge. So I believe that has been a learning for me, and that is what probably has made me to think and look life very different. Today in my office, if somebody does not know English, I love them because there is a likelihood they've got a great knowledge.
No, but I'll tell you, when you look back to all these instances, did this actually make you learn the language more, English language, because you felt, oh my God, I was rejected because of it, so I need to learn the language more, or did you still focus only on knowledge?
I think I kept on focusing on knowledge till I got a decent job, till I understood, now I can polish my English. And I said I did so many tuitions. While I did so many tuitions, the guy who was sitting in front of me was a rich boy's son. He didn't learn anything. I improved my English. So if you notice, my English has got improved only after the age of 27. And till today, it is becoming perfect. And today, I don't bother about the English, because the content, if it is good, then once again, language has no issue.
So talking about joining your first job, was it that capsule manufacturing company that you joined? Was that your first job?
Yes, that is the job where I got 150 rupees per month. It's not 150 pounds per hour. 150 Indian rupees per month. And mind you, I wanted to get married when I get 1,000 rupees per month. Fortunately, that company was closed down, otherwise I might have remained unmarried even today.
So it was fortunately.
Everything has happened fortunately. Had I that company not collapsed that time, by that time when it collapses, I might have collapsed. It is good that something fails that too early, so that you start looking for opportunities and you get best. If somebody got a good job immediately after college, there is a likelihood he will never be successful.
So good, all you people out there, if you haven't got a good job already at a young age, it's good for you, all right? There's a bigger picture, right?
Celebrate,
party, because you don't have a good job at a young age. You have a very interesting story about how you met your wife and stuff like that.
I think everyone has an interesting story. Only thing is they don't know how interesting it is when they narrate. In my case, my father-in-law and my mother-in-law spotted that I'm a potential boy for their daughter. So they kept on walking to me a couple of times. Then I thought I will have a look at the girl and then decide about it. I looked at the girl and the girl was not at all impressive. So I thought I will not marry. But then my in-laws were kept on persuading me. Then I thought I will sit next to her and discourage her so much. She tells her father, I don't want this boy. This was an attempt.
And how did you dissuade her? Like you kept saying, I've got these bad qualities. I'm not the right kind of guy for you.
In a balance sheet, I took away all the assets and put into the liability side. So I felt that lady will see that this man has nothing and she would not agree to marry me. And to my surprise, she wanted to marry only me. And after a month of getting engaged, I asked my wife, what was that in spite of all this, you agree to marry me? She said, and I want all ladies to remember in their life, she said, I didn't want to become a small daughter-in-law in a big house. I wanted to be a tall daughter-in-law in a small house. I have decided to marry you.
Wow.
So I am thankful that she took a decision once again to the contrary. And then she is a lady whom probably was not attractive enough to say yes at the first sight, but reluctantly I married. Who knows that she would remain as the backbone for my entire journey. Today, I look back for the last 30 years, it was she who made me what I am today, what is Thyrocare today. So that's the thing which we must learn from life.
And also to appreciate the women in our lives, who are actually the silent superheroes.
Absolutely, they remain behind the successful stories, successful people, and the front end is very often a man, not a lady.
You also got a government job. Did you last there long? Did they sack you? Did you leave out of frustration? How was it?
If they sack you, you are gone. But if you have left voluntarily, you are successful. This is how life is. Once I felt, this job is not going to take me anywhere, I knew what would be my emoluments at my date of retirement. I didn't find any thrill there. So I took a decision. I was a frugal man. I had enough money in my closing balance account. Then I took a decision, even without discussing with my wife, I resigned. Even without discussing with my mother, I married. Even without discussing with my father, I came to Mumbai. And I want you to understand very clearly, in life, either you can discuss or you can decide. If you discuss, you can't decide. And if you have decided, there is no need for any discussion. In fact, the punchline is, there is nothing known as good decision. There is a decision, and make it good.
Wow. So you mean to say that every decision you took in your life, you were the sole person responsible for it?
Absolutely. Without that, success never comes. In fact, if you discuss, you get discouraged.
Has there been an incident in your life when you actually discussed it with someone and it's backfired?
I take decisions and I do a trial of discussion.
How does that work?
Because anyhow you have taken a decision. The decision is going on. Then I discuss with my people to understand it. As expected, all of them will discourage. I want you to clearly understand you have two options in life. One is what is easy to do. Another is what is right to do. What is easy to do is not right to do. What is right to do is not easy to do. I don't know what you will do. So, in fact, if you want to know what is right, make people to sit in front of you, those who love you the most. Tell them what you want to do. If all of them say, don't do, please do it. Because they love you the most. They don't want you to do what is difficult to do. All of them will tell you what is right, what is easy to do. And easy to do is not right to do. So this is in fact, a simple way you can learn and you can proceed.
So as the promoter of Thyrocare, which is huge, it's big, do you still, till date, take decisions on your own and don't discuss? Because you're running an empire.
Earlier days, in fact, there was a temptation to discuss, because all knew and all were your own stage, all knew as much as you know. Today I am in a position, I only from that height know what I am doing, and if I go and discuss with everyone, it is stupidity. So I today take bolder decisions, very, very split of a second, and I take it on my own and I don't involve. My wife was never a part of discussion. My children were not a part of discussion. My siblings are not a part of discussion, and I take a decision. Investors also at times are not part of discussion. If I don't want to decide, I will sit and discuss, because you have got an opportunity to discuss. But all decisions which I have decided without discussing have added one more zero in my life.
You're truly making us realize the power of zero, huh?
Power of zero, power of decision making. I think this is, if somebody can take decision, that means he is the true leader. And if somebody struggles to make a decision, it's very difficult to follow.
No, but sometimes discussions are also based, because one is not only an individual force. After a point, one becomes the force for his employees, force for his family. So sometimes a person ends up discussing because he needs to take his other people along. He's scared that if he takes that wrong decision, it might upset or affect the people around him, right?
You have answered it. You said he is scared. The scared one cannot take decisions. The daring one only takes the decision. And without daring decisions, which business can be prosperous? Without a risk, which business can give you rewards? I think people are dreaming for secured prosperity. When security and prosperity, there is no connection. You can either dream for a security or prosperity. So if you ask me, you have to take decisions, bold decisions. I have seen all people who have taken bold decisions. They have been successful. Everyone who is scared and taken a decision are failing. So you need to have boldness to take a decision and stick to decision. There can be challenges. There can be lot of resistance. But if you have conviction, you have got it.
So remember, it's all about being bold. It's about being daring. It's about not discussing, and taking decisions. Ones who spend time in discussing don't take decisions. The moral of the story, this is how you become the architect of your life. Remember, you're watching Velumani's 4G, Guts, Grit, Growth and Glory. I am Siddharth Kannan. This is our small endeavor in making you realize your own potential and how you can touch a higher purpose in life by just being a person who's daring and bold. See you, sir, very soon in the next episode. Bye-bye.
Thank you.
Bye.